Last week, Mr. Gatto's and Mrs. Doomer's 8th grade students debated in the media center on what to do about the Syrian refugee crisis. It's a global hot button issue with no easy answer. Students researched about the crisis for several days before the event. Each class period included multiple classes at the same time, with as many as 65 students participating at once. The debates also included extra events this year, with live commentating during each debate.
Did you know that as a country, America's in $19.9 trillion of debt? Or that more than 45 million people in America live below the poverty line? There's an estimated number of 1.9 billion Syrians in the world. How do you expect us to care for them all?
This is a matter of basic human rights. There is no person, no matter of their gender, race, or religion, that should live in fear for their life or the lives of their close ones.
Why would you deny them of coming to a country where they can be safe? Would you rather have them as an enemy or as ally?
If they come to our country, then there's more people in our country to take our jobs and more of the workers for our country.
These poor people are planning their lives here in the U.S. They're planning for better care for them as well as their families. And they are counting on us in their times of need because they no longer have anything. Refugees are not terrorists. They are often the first victims of terrorism.
We have a quick word from our sponsors and our guys over at the top of the table. Guys, how's it going?
The four side really had some good stuff. JC and Matea, they both had some really good comments. I think they're gaining some momentum.
I'd agree with you there, Roger. I would say that the four side is really having some good comments, but I think the against side is firing back just as well.
I think we should take in more refugees because we're one of the most developed countries and we can handle more refugees than like other poor countries.
Should take in refugees, but also Canada, because they have roughly let in 35,000, but they have had no reported foreign terrorist attacks.
Countries like Turkey, Lebanon, Jordan, Iraq, and Syria, they've taken in so many refugees, their economy isn't even stable anymore. If they take in many more, they're going to collapse completely.
We think that Europe should be taking in more of the refugees because their economy is strong, they have room for it, and it would be a close travel for the refugees, keeping them safe. Under some circumstances, we can let some refugees in if they have the background check like they're doing in Jordan. We can let in safe, checked refugees, but not big, random groups.
Well, each country that has a population of at least 250,000 and is capable of doing so, we're taking at least 20,000 or more refugees as a requirement of the UN. That would house nearly 4 million refugees, which is nearly all who are in need of help right now.
Andy's coming!
Ms. Stoltz's art students were given an assignment of creating doodles for Google with the theme of What I See for the Future. Several students chose to participate in the Doodles for Google contest, and Ms. Stoltz sent the entries in on December 2nd to Google. Way to go, students, and good luck to our contestants. The other top choice designs that don't fit the Google contest theme will be featured in Stoltz's room in the Artist of the Week display. Stop in and check out some great art.
I'm Sam Faber.
And I'm Sam Wicken.
And we're here with Mrs. Krause. She teaches digital citizenship and You're the Boss.
What are some things you can tell us about these classes?
Well, digital citizenship is a class that we teach here at the middle school that gets kids prepared for the high school technology that they use. So we do a lot of projects with the Google application, so Google Slides and Google Sheets and Google Docs. We also do different presentations as well. Digital citizenship is a class that we also talk about internet safety. And You're the Boss is a class that is an entrepreneur class. So we talk about how to start businesses and different ideas about business. Kids will do a Shark Tank simulation where they create a business and a business plan. And then they present that to sharks that are DECA students from the high school. And those DECA students will give the kids pretend money to start their business with. And after they are awarded the money from the Shark Tank simulation, they can earn money for their business by creating different products for it. So they'll do advertisements and logos, coupons, all sorts of different projects that they can use to earn money for their business.
Annie's coming!
Seventh and eighth grade boys basketball starts January 3rd, and the registration fee is $65. Sixth grade will start on January 9th, and the fee is $25. So stop in the office and get signed up. And don't forget to order your DMS yearbook online before winter break at www.jostinsyearbooks.com for only $25. There are also copies of the order form available in the office.